In the yards of the Romanian capital of Bucharest, Harry Dodge recorded a plethora of locomotives which have long since disappeared. The alliance between Germany and Romania lasted until the 1940s and strongly influenced the design of the CFR's motive power. For almost 50 years, the Romanians made wide use of well-proven German designs. This long freight train is pulled by an elderly 260, assisted by a Class 150 210, based on the Deutsche Reichsbahn Class 50. The ever-popular Prussian P8s, G8s and G10s were also built in large numbers under license in Romania. Austrian locomotives, too, were used in large numbers by the CFR, as well as those of Hungary, America, and finally, Russia, as Romania's borders underwent massive contortions following both world wars. This Romanian Class 230 10-wheeler on passenger duty is actually a Prussian P10, while on the other side of the yard, a Class 150 goes about its duties. One unique feature of CFR power was the practice of burning a mixture of coal and oil, and this resulted in the addition of an oil tank on top of the tender water tank, directly behind the coal bunker. A few years after Harry's visit, steam was disappearing rapidly from the CFR, as diesel and electric units were introduced in increasing numbers. But it was not just the Germanic decapods, but also the older pre-war Hungarian locomotives that were still in service during the last few years of Romanian steam. Thank you. also near Bucharest, but this time on Romanian narrow gauge, Harry Dodge found this 080 tank engine, number 764411, shunting in the yards. Like most of the country's narrow gauge lines, the engines were on the elderly side and had their origins in Germany, Austria, and even Russia. Standard gauge, this time in Oradea, Harry filmed one of the delightful Class 324 262s as she pulled a passenger train into the station. A Class 50 010 shunted in the yards. Nearly a quarter of the Romanian steam power consisted of these Prussian G10s, more than 800 of which were ordered between 1921 and 1942. Having dropped its passengers, the Class 324 then ran round its train before coupling up and setting out again for a run along the line. With Hungary is the setting of our last glimpse of Romanian steam. Charging across this bleak Balkan farmland is the most famous of all Romanian locomotives, the imposing Class 142. 79 of these 284s were built, and they were exact duplicates of the Austrian 214 class from the 1930s. Romanian 142s were soon in the majority, as only 13 Austrian versions ever saw the light of day.
Romania, in 1995, still had a number of active steam locos, used mostly only on special workings. Many Romanian locos originated from German builders. Examples include this G10 on mainline excursion duties, carrying Romanian number 50047. These 010 freight engines began to appear from the early 1900s. German-built P8 460s, as seen in Poland, also found their way to Romania. Number 230142 is a popular choice for special tour trains. Note the small smoke deflectors attached to the chimney. This well-turned-out Kriegsloch, with almost identical appearance to those seen in Poland, can also be found on special tour trains. Another splendid-looking locomotive from the German stable is this Series 231 Pacific. Built by Henschel in 1922, this express passenger design is another popular choice for special tour trains. Thank you. Romanian built in 1939, this elegant 284 Series 142 can also be regularly seen on tour trains. As standard gauge meets narrow gauge, we're reminded, like Poland, regular steam-worked narrow gauge railways across Romania have now virtually disappeared, apart from special operations. Such an example of this is seen here north of Bucharest. The two locos in charge are an 080 well tank and a Romanian version PX48, which is similar in appearance to the Polish variant. One active, steam-worked forestry railway survived into the 21st century. The 750mm gauge Visur de Sur system, close to the Ukraine border, still gathers timber from the remote forests of the Carpathian Mountains. Class 764-080 tanks are the usual motive power on the 41 kilometres long route along the Weser Valley. Most locos emanated from Hungarian, German, and Romanian builders. The most recent improved version, 764s, to the same design, were produced in the 1980s. A passenger service is also provided for timber workers and locals. Thank you. Historic 1921 German-built 763 class 060 tank is occasionally pressed into service on special trains. Water is replenished from the river by means of the loco steam pump. Munich-built 460 tank is seen on the now closed Kommandau forestry system.